Hey people, my name is Gerbrand and I've been a collector of vintage computers for a very, very, very long time. Here in Holland we are still in lockdown. I have still the Corona coup, I have to say. I hope that will be over soon, but we cannot hurry our health, I think. Anyways, today we're gonna unpack some more vintage computers, of course. The nice Atari E for extended or whatever that you saw in the thumbnail. I'm really, really happy that I have one of these because I've been after one of these for a very long time and they're always very expensive. This time I was lucky because I could buy it for somebody who was selling something that he didn't know really what it was. I couldn't really see what is on the picture. So I asked him, what is on the backside of the computer? What is there? And it said, oh, STE. And I was like, yes, I need to have this. Yes. So really excited about that. And it's also something very British for our British viewers today. And something else. Let's have a look. Next up is not a computer, but a keyboard. And if I say keyboard, then maybe you can guess what kind of keyboard this is, what company made this keyboard. Make an estimated guess and put it in the comments below before you continue and we'll see if you got it right. It's expensive. It was expensive to buy and I hope to get some money for it. And let's have a look. Many times you can see by the box if the seller did a good job. I think this one did. It looks good because the keyboard is not so very big. The box is big. I think I will be happy. Let's have a look. The box in the box, very good. Maybe you can see what it is. I'll take a closer look. Very, very, very nice. I saw it in the advertisement and I thought this one is looking very good. It looks like, no, maybe it looks almost like new. It's an of course the IBM Model M, and yeah, it looks great. This is the clicky. This is the one. Even modern gamers nowadays, they want this one because it's nothing, there's nothing you can compare to this one. It comes with a cable, PS2. So it's a little bit more modern than the big original DIN stickers plugs. We'll test it out. But first we'll have a little closer look at this beauty. I'm really, really glad that it's exactly as I thought it would be. This will be a good item to sell. If I sell these, normally I buy a complete set of IBM computer, IBM monitor and IBM keyboard. And the keyboards I sell separately. And I sell them really, really quick, I think. And I think this one will do good because it's in really great shape. Here you can see the original label. It has the feet, of course. And cable will help. Let's try this little puppy out. And now we're on the keyboardtester.com site to test this keyboard. My computer is not the fastest, but I think it's working all right, so this seems to work all fine. Caps, print screen, and that lot, and this lot, and here we have some. Remaining of the keyboard, enter, space, shift, control, alt, there's no Windows keys of course, control, this works, alt, okay, it responds to everything, all is the same, numeral keys. Yeah, we can safely say that this machine, this fine keyboard, is working. All right. Next up is some Astari stuff. I know there's always been a long, long battle between Commodore and Atari, and I'm not about to choose because I sell both. I bought two Atari machines, and they're a little different. One is for me to keep. I want to keep the nicest one, the rarest one, and the other one is for selling. And let's have a look. This is the first box. It's the first Atari computer, and it looks very good. I don't think there can be anything wrong with this, but we'll have a look. The number of clothes and blankets and whatever and pillows and stuff that I got through the years, I think I can decorate your whole house with this. This is a new one. It's not looking very dirty, that's what makes me happy, but apart from that, I always throw this out because you never know what touched it. Here we have number one, Atari 1040 STF, and it's one of the most common Atari STs, I think, STs. Made in Thailand. It looks good. All the keys are here. QWERTY. This is number one. Let's unpack number two. Number two. I hope this is the Atari STE for enhanced. This box been lying around in my room for quite some time. I would really, really, really like to this to be the enhanced version because it's very difficult to get. And let's have a look. This startled me a little bit because this is obviously a printer part. I don't hope there's a printer in here, but I think the rest is okay. And here's a side-by-side comparison. Here is the lovely E. It's a little bit difficult to see, but it's really the E. I cleaned it up a little bit and you can see that it looks exactly like the F and the FM and everything else. The E also came with the mouse. Always very happy with that. They look very good. And let's try these out and let's see the difference between these machines. Okay, thanks to some nice Facebook groups, I know that I have to you use this program, sysinfo. Oh, okay. No problem. I hope this works. Come on. Let's see what we've got. Oh, this is nice. Look at this. Type is a 1040 SDE. That is the one. And the total SD RAM is 1024 kilobytes. It's 1 megabyte. That's not really a lot, I think, for an SDE. And there's some other options. Well, this is interesting. Let's try some other memory. And here we have a little closer look of the inside of the Atari SDE. We've got our memory here in nice memory banks, so we can switch it easily. And I'm not really a real Atari knowledgeable person, but I see that there are extra joystick ports over here, and there are some audio connectors over here, and that's all I can see right now. But it looks very interesting, and we will see if we can upgrade this memory and get that demo to work. Here are the original memory banks, and over here we have some replacements. I think this will be 4 megabytes, and that will be enough, I hope. And here is the machine all assembled, or almost assembled, and with the new memory. Where is Gerben at? He's at the topless bar, of course, but because that makes him very, very, very happy. Will it work? Well, let's see. 4 megabytes. Let's have a look. Oh, this is nice. Look at this. 4096 kilobytes. 4 megabytes. It's the same. This looks very, very good. Cool. And now it's time to test our demo. Will it finally work? The MUDA demo. Let's see. Oh, this is good. And it seems the other STF is French. This is very like the first time for me. Disc Mary on move on the MUDA. Mais le même jaar insuffisant pour la application et en cours. Well, you can hear my French is almost as good as my English, so it's not good at all. I will have to look a little bit further for this.
Moyen, conformé, disque A. Oh, this is nice.
The type is just a normal ST. It's from France. No kidding. And it's got 1 megabyte. So that's very standard, I think. Nice, nice to see. This works.
Hello.
Hello. Sorry. Oh. In 1984, I think, Mr. Clive made a successor to his first, or not his first, but one of his most successful computers. This one is a little bit more with a regular keyboard, and I think I understand these a little bit better, because the original with the dead meat keyboard, it was always very confusing to me. A nephew of mine had one, and we visited him one time, and he was like, I press this key and that key and that key and that key and that key, and then all of the things happened, and it was really strange, because I was used to MSX, and I have to type in C loads, up, 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 up. And he was like, doop, 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 ready. Well, anyway, enough talk. Let's see what's in the box. Here we have it. It looks like a sturdy box. Let's have a look. You can almost see what it is. I think you know. Sinclair ZX Spectrum Plus, very nice. This was the successor to the normal Spectrum, and the normal Spectrum was the one that my nephew showed me. I'm really curious, because a lot of times the keyboard is malfunctioning. So let's have a look. Let's open this and see what we can find. Sinclair ZX Spectrum Plus, very nice. Oh, look at this. A lot of Dutch computers have these little stickers from the original owners or the original company they owned. And there are enough, I think. The computer and a tape.
And it's still sealed. Look at this. Oh, this is nice. The power supply and TV lead, data cable. No, oh, that looks very, very nice. Let's give this this little baby a test. And now for the moment of truth, will it work? Oh, this is good. Yes, very nice. And let's see if I remember what I have to do. I have to press the J and the this one's and so. This is loading from the computer. It's loading very, very fast. Look at this. Very cool, but I'm about to die, I think. Oh no, it's going okay. Anyway, very nice. Well, it works. Here is a view of the OTLA program, and it's fairly easy. Just new and add, and we take the Batman, open it. It's okay. And if we hit play, this is how you load in real time.
We came to the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I like making these videos a lot, but you know that. And I think we had some new, some nice computers this time, and I'm really happy that I can load programs from not from only from tape but also from the computer directly. I'm learning also a little bit every time, and I hope you're learning a little bit with me. And if you're already subscribed, please share this video with your friends so that the channel can grow. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and please like, because that really, really helps. And I hope to see all of you in good health next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.